with the changing climate, we've found that fires are a lot more severe than they used to be. If something gets absolutely hit with extreme heat, the dung beetles leave. They don't come back. The insects and everything are dormant, nothing grows. So when something gets thrown out, usually the entire system gets thrown out. So we're trying to work out ways that bring dung beetles back into that area later on, and right now just figure out why they haven't returned, what else isn't working out, and hopefully come to a solution at the end. My name is Ethan Towns. I'm a Kamilaroi person from Wee-Waw. In ACRI, Narrabri. It's between Wee-Waw and Narrabri in New South Wales. And currently I'm working on dung beetles and other dung dwelling bugs that may be able to assist in putting nutrients back into the soil. Dung beetle is a scarab that flies towards dung, and they will grab all of the dung and put it back underneath the soil. It makes holes for water to go through, and plants take up nutrients and put it in the grass, and the animal eats it. Unless that nutrients is put back into the soil will eventually just lose all its nutrients, and then things won't be able to grow. Still trying to figure out actual breeding mechanisms of these other beetles, and we really got to see what the actual heat limits are for all of these insects. So that's the next step, is usually in science you reference other papers to get an idea of what's happening, but currently there are no papers to reference from, so it's really challenging starting from the ground up, basically keying them in from the very start. Before my PhD, I used to work in cotton, looking at Helicoverpa armigera and puntigera, a grub that absolutely decimates cotton, and it used to be a real problem. I was in that for 5 years, and what we found is one whole species won't eat during the very start of the season. So just conventional cotton works better, and that's something nobody knew or even really thought about. And then I had to give a speech about it in front of over 100 scientists around the world. But it was very exciting to show off my research. I have always liked insects. There's pictures of me at 3 years old with a bug catcher, just walking around and lifting up rocks as a kid. I've just always liked the fact that the world basically runs by insects, this big circle of just insects doing everything. My love of it and being able to like know so much has really helped around here, because when people are struggling to breed an insect, I'm like, well, I used to do that just for fun. Insects are just a very cool thing. With my PhD right now, it is through UNE, but the CSIRO has offered me a top-up scholarship. So even though university is in Armidale, which is about 3.5 hours away, I'm able to do it out here with given access to the farmlands, glasshouses, any resources around the lab that I need. And then I get to work in a nature reserve, so people aren't even allowed out there. So it's places that are barely touched by other people. So you really get to see just how much nature Australia can offer. I do like being out here. It is just wide open areas. We have heaps of different animals that you've probably never seen before. Just overall, the community in the CSIRO is great. Like, the people out here are nice, very accepting of you, and are always willing to lend a hand. And a lot of times the CSIRO people around here will actually implement your ideas, or even give you the time to do a little tiny study, which could end up becoming a really big thing. A lot of people, when they finish their degree, don't have a job, where the CSIRO really tries to bring, especially someone they've paid for to get trained up, back into the workforce. So a lot of the times you're set up with a job when you're done, which is something that a lot of people don't get. I started off with work experience in year 10, traineeship 11 and 12, and then cadetship for university. My cadetship was probably the best thing that they did. They paid off majority of my hex. So if you want to come, they will follow you the entire way, and they encourage you to actually be able to go through with science and use your Indigenous side of thinking to actually help out. And your ideas will be important here. I'd like to be able to stop climate change, but it's probably going to continue to go. So my legacy right now would be really looking at
how we can continue to keep going if things are changing. I think the CSIRO, since it brings you into such awareness of the world and how sensitive ecosystems can be, if the next generation is led by people like us, we will likely make a lot better decisions in the future to make sure we actually have a sustainable Australia.